In the previous video, I installed my tangential knife and laser adapter mount to the Z-axis of the Moot One desktop CNC machine. And in this video, I will explain how I wired the laser to the Duet controller and the relevant workflow for its use. So to start, this is the laser head, which was sent to me by Op Lasers with an S to use and review. They had previously sent me the older type back in 2017, but this is the much newer version, which contains new functionality, including safety features. The body is the PLH3D 6W XF Plus, and this also includes the uSpot upgrade, or meSpot upgrade, and comes in at a hefty £635.10 when not on discount. Noticeable changes include an arming LED on the head to keep you aware of what's going on, plus upon dinging around the thick user manual, the option to use a 0-10V signal, which is enabled by flicking a switch on the laser head's internal electronics. The uSpot lens focuses the diode laser beam to a sharper point and is designed to increase the efficiency of the engraving cutting process. Op Lasers suggest up to 2.5 times higher speeds compared to the standard version, but I'll be the judge of that. In addition to all that, this setup also includes the high pressure air assist nozzle kit, which comes in at an eye-watering £109.49, but it is a wonderfully machined piece of aluminium, and offers a further 6.5 times speed increase for cutting and engraving compared to the standard base. I assume this is achieved by blasting any smoke away from the focal point and also turning the focal point into a mini blast furnace. This little bundle of danger is installed onto a LaserDock magnetic docking station, which is an additional £123.37. The docking station is designed to allow the laser head to be quickly removed or connected to the machine, in part to prevent it from being damaged by dust during the normal cutting process of the spindle router.
Hello? Oh, yeah, I'm actually working on the video right now. Polished all the aluminium, it's gonna look fantastic.
When removed, the docking mount includes an aluminium cover that can be swapped out. Now all of that is connected to the PLH3D CNC adapter, which is inside my enclosure, and at its bare essentials costs £86.87. The CNC adapter is actually the most interesting thing I find, because it is a go-between pretty much any controller out there and the typical input for a laser head. I suspect you could probably run a cheaper laser more safely with one of these, but when the laser head is combined with this adapter, you have the best quality diode laser on the market, without a doubt. Altogether, the total price is £954.83, which might seem a lot, but the running cost of a CO2 laser can be several thousand pounds a year, especially for vacuum tube brakes. So to wiring this up, you will need a separate power supply from the rest of your controller and stepper electronics. This can be anything from 15 to 24 volts, but I'm using a 24 volt 3.2 amp meanwhile power supply from RS Components. On my controller, this goes to the DC power terminal on the adapter, with the cable including an inline ferrite core. The terminals on the left of the adapter are wired through the CNC trunking to the laser head, and include voltage in and ground, which are at the top, followed by the signal ground, TTL and analog 5 volts. For additional safety, I've wired a key switch and my main e-stop to the terminals at the top left, which break the power if opened. The key is left normally open when the laser is not armed, while the emergency stop contact opens when pressed, cutting power to the laser head in case of a catastrophe. On the right hand side are the inputs from the controller. There I've wired the PWM TTL input, terminal 2, from the Duex.PWM5 header on the Duex5 board. Below that is terminal 3, which is the enable 1 input, which I have 5 volts coming in from the same Duex header, however this time via normally open relay module. I use the E5.heat terminal to switch the relay whenever I change to the laser tool within the Duet web controller, in my case tool 0. Terminal 4 goes back to ground on the same Duex PWM5 header. This is a diagram of the Duex board, and it's important to note here that the PWM servo channels are shared with the heater ones. As I'm using the PWM5 terminal, I will not be using the E6 heater for anything else. There is also a red warning label at the bottom corner to remind us. Now you will have to program your adapter for the particular enable input states, and this is done by switching the key off, pressing the red arming button, turning the key back on, and waiting a few seconds. You can then press the arming button to toggle between these enable input states. I'm using program option 2, where enable 1 expects a high input and enable 2 is any or ignored. You may also need to select your head type as well, by doing the same procedure, but waiting until the LED performs some kind of light run twice to show you these options. With option 0, if the head is armed and then removed, returning the laser will allow it to power back up again. And option 2 will result in discontinuity and having to re-press the red arming button. Annoyingly, and this is my only complaint, I must open my enclosure to arm the laser, and the adapter should really have an extension for that button so the electronics can be kept isolated. This is my wiring diagram for my setup, which you can pause to have a look at. A clearer and more up-to-date version will be available to my patrons along with the relevant Duet files while I'm still working on this, after which I plan to release this publicly. Okay, I'll now talk about the Duet settings, and it's important to mention my CNC machine will have four tools. Tool 0 is the laser, tool 1 is the spindle router and main tool, tool 2 is a pen plotter attachment, and tool 3 is a experimental tangential knife. On screen is the relevant part for the tools within the config.g file in the system folder. And in case you were wondering, I'm using the latest firmware version, which is RepRap firmware 3.3.0. M453 sets the machine to CNC mode, while M950 defines which pin will be used for the spindle on and RPM. M563P0 defines the tool name and number, with laser assigned to tool 0, and you can see for P1 the spindle is assigned to tool 1 with R1, while P2 is the pen plotter and P3 the tangential knife. Additionally, I have also included another M950 command to define the pin which will trigger the relay module that sends the signal to the enable 1 input on the adapter, and by default that is off. No tool is selected within my config file, as when I load a cutting job from my CAM software, VCarve Desktop, I define the tool used by its database number. Within the system file, each tool can have a associated tpre-number.g file, t3.g file, and tpost.g file. When I select tool 0, tpre0.g is called, and I use an M452 command to select laser mode, defining the pin that will send the signal to the CNC adapter, the working range, which in my case is 255 for maximum power, and the PWM frequency. I also use the M42 command to switch the enable 1 input on the CNC adapter to high. G10L2P2 sets the Z height for the G55 work coordinate, which is worked out from a separate setting up macro, so the tool body is 60mm away from the wasteboard. Within T30.g, I turn the enable 1 signal to low so the laser cannot be accidentally turned on. The X and Y axis offset between the fixed tools, 0, 1 and 3, is worked out by yet another macro that I've written. I begin by marking a cross on a sacrificial surface, the thickness of which I must manually add to the macro itself. After which I can jog tool 1 to the center of the mark from tool 0 with a V-bit in the collet, saving the location to a spare work coordinate. I then remove the tool from the collet and place another V-bit into tool 3, the tang knife head, and jog to the same mark and save that to a third work coordinate. The offsets I worked out and saved along the way to the tool number and are recalled whenever the tool is selected. I'm now going to engrave a shape and then laser into the engraving to demonstrate the accuracy between the two tools. And as you can see, it seems pretty good. This setup might be useful for going between milling a cradle for an object to be held and then to laser engrave onto that object. I've also thought about using the laser to spot solder components onto a PCB, and in theory with this setup I could mill a PCB myself and quite easily give it a shot. So I think this video is over. Please check out the links in the description for additional information and let me know if you have any comments or questions down below. I'm pretty much done with the controller build now, apart from possibly wiring an air pump and solenoid valves, but I'm still thinking about whether it's worth doing that. As always, thanks again for watching, and to my patrons for their support. You'll catch me in the next one. This is visually and functionally a spectacularly made piece of equipment with wonderfully machined aluminium details, which make it feel like a part of the International Space Station.